now confirmed that victim, Nikayla Strawder, was 15 years old, and the suspected shooter, a 9-year-old boy. We've also learned that the gun used in the shooting is registered to a woman related to that 9-year-old. And WJZ is live tonight. Annie Rose Ramos joins us at the scene of the shooting. And Annie Rose, you spoke to her father tonight. What did he have to say?
Well, Kelsey, we're learning a lot more about what happened here at 600 Leonard Street last night, where 15-year-old Nikayla Strawder was shot and killed right outside of her home. Police telling us that that gun was accidentally discharged. As her father says, he'll never be the same. Tonight, a grief-stricken father coming to grips with the death of his daughter.
It's not going to be the same without my daughter. We will never be the same without her.
Dante Jones says he was upstairs at home with his wife and other children when he heard sounds coming from his front porch Saturday evening.
He heard like a loud, muffled sound because he couldn't really tell if it was a gunshot.
Coming downstairs to find his 15-year-old daughter, Nikayla Strawder, bleeding.
From her head, actually from the back of her head, or the side. I couldn't really tell because there was so much blood everywhere and I was so excited. Upset because of what was happening to my child.
Officers arrived. Found the victim on the porch right behind me, a minor female victim.
Police IDing the shooter as a 9-year-old boy, who they say was playing with a loaded handgun when it accidentally discharged.
Minors were on the porch, gun was present. At some point, that gun was discharged.
The 9-year-old child dropping the gun and fleeing the scene. Police say the gun belongs to the 9-year-old child's relative, who is an armed security guard.
We are at multiple scenes trying to gather as many witnesses and as much information as we can.
Now, Nikayla's father, Dante, has a message for his daughter's shooter.
What I do want you to know is that we took my child from us. We took a very precious angel away from the world.
Hey y'all, what's up? We back, and I definitely have a story that I definitely want to get y'all opinion on, because I'm definitely, you know, torn on what happened, what the media saying happened, and what the streets are saying happened. So this story goes back to Baltimore, Maryland, and beautiful young lady here in the red dress, she was shot by a 9-year-old little boy. Okay, media outlets have reported that. Police have also reported that due to his age, he will not be charged. Now, of course, you have some people understanding, okay, that's the law. Now, on the other half, like, nah, take the law into your own hands because it wasn't an accident. So, again, news sources are saying that it was an accident, allegedly, that, you know, he was playing around with the gun and somehow it discharged and struck the little girl on the side of her head, almost, you know, killing her instantly. So as days go on, the truth comes out. You know, you have one side, you have the other side, and somewhere lies in the middle is the truth. Okay, so I'm gonna throw in a few clippings here just to give y'all what the streets are saying versus what the main media is saying. And let me see how you feel, you know, after seeing what has happened. Now, I do have sources here in Baltimore because, again, these are my stopping grounds. And they have confirmed what the streets are saying has happened. And it's unfortunately that a 14-year-old little girl had to lose her life due to this. But again, please be kind to like, subscribe, and share, and we can definitely make more content like this. Well, while we wait, let me just throw in these few clippings just to see how do y'all feel about the situation.